The way I came to a method was through listening. I just follow what it wants. If it's going to be a song, if it's going to be a murmur, if it's going to be a drawing. My process is not thinking. My process is sensing, attending to that that is around us in our field of love, I would say. The things that you love. I can tell you a scene. I am in the South Pacific, in Chile, in the beach. I am maybe 17 years old. And I was playing in the beach, and suddenly the movement of the wind around my waist made me feel that the wind was sensing me, feeling me. And I looked into the sea, and I felt that the sea was also aware. And I suddenly became aware all in one blow that everything was aware. And I understood in that moment that my awareness was possible because everything was aware. I felt such awe and reverence in front of that, that I kneeled down and I grabbed a little palito, I call them, little sticks that are lying around, and I planted it, made it vertical. In 1966, that is the birth of the precarios. Precario means fragile. It means something that disappears. In high school, we studied that Chile was becoming a desert as a result of colonization. And so water was already becoming scarce back in the 60s. You fast forward to the military coup in Chile, 73, and the dictatorship privatized water. The precarios instantly became a prayer for the well-being of water, became an offering for the restoration of the life force of the water. And to this day, I sense what is happening to water as if it was happening inside of me. Quipu is an ancient system that the pre-Columbian people developed in Peru, and it is a form of record keeping that inscribed information through tying knots on threads. So information was encoded in such complex ways that it has as many iterations as the alphabetic system in terms of all that can be encoded in knots and turns and twists. I began doing quipus in the 60s. When I returned to Chile, I began creating these sort of quipus that are composed of people, where instead of me creating knots in threads, I could weave people. I suppose I began first as a political act of joining people together as a way of going against the Western idea of separation, of individualism, and so forth. But eventually, this became something deeper than that even, which is connecting our collective body to the movement of water. Mapocho is the river at which side I was born. It connects the glacier of El Plomo to the Pacific Ocean, and it passes through the middle of Santiago. This river is sort of disappearing from drought, global warming, and this kidnapping of water by privatization. I have done very many rituals there, but the Quipu Mapocho consisted in doing 8 or 9 performances all the way from the glacier to the ocean and all those middle points. And in most of those points, I would do it with large groups of people woven together, weaving their bodies to the water, symbolically or literally. the awareness that the Valley of Santiago used to be a sacred landscape, not only for the ancient people that were originally there, but also to the Incas, was completely erased by colonial Western culture. I want to bring this awareness that the sacred landscape was still alive and still with us and still speaking to us if we just listened to it.